Hi, my name's Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to introduce video editing in Google Web Designer. I start by creating a new blank file and selecting Video Ed. Set the size, give it a name, and OK. Now I can author audio, video, and animation, and my final output would be a standard MP4 video file. It's not tied to any ad platform, it's not a web-based HTML project, and it's not interactive. It's a plain video. I don't even need video assets. I can create my own animation with text and images and export a video file that could be shared on YouTube or used as an asset in an interactive ad. Add audio and video clips by dragging directly to the stage or into the library panel or by file import assets. Library assets can be dragged either onto the stage or into a track. The frame rate of the entire doc would be set automatically to match the first clip added, and it can be changed in the Properties panel. You can use videos with different frame rates, and they'll all be normalized to the document frame rate. If I want to change the size of my video, I can select it on stage or select a track and then move or resize it with a transform control or use the Properties panel. Note the scaling option, which also controls how the video is resized, and a lot of other controls like opacity and rounded corners, which should be familiar for GWD users. All these settings affect every clip in the track. All clips will be resized to these dimensions. I'll delete these extra tracks and use the alignment buttons to position this one. Now for some video editing. First, I notice there's some background audio in this source that I'm not planning to use, so I'll select the audio track and delete it. Now I scrub through the video, and I want to remove this opening shot. Set the playhead at the point I want to start, hover near the end of the clip, and drag to trim the endpoint. Next, I want to start this clip just after the truck passes, and I want about 2 seconds of this clip. Note the timeline reads in minutes, seconds, and frames are the last two numbers, not hundredths of a second like other file types. Plus, I'm constantly zooming in and out of the timeline a lot, so I'm counting frames based on the frame rate. At 2 seconds, I right-click to split the clip, also called a cut. Now for the next shot, I want the drone footage to start just before the car crests the hill. And hold this until the car leaves the frame. Then I want to rearrange these so the drone clip is first. And last is to trim this so that my total time is 6 seconds. Now I'll set a transition by hovering over the intersection of these two clips. Click the little plus icon and choose a preset like fade. Then adjust the duration to a half a second or 12 frames in this case. And the last step is to add my audio track, which is 6 seconds long. I can use stage playback to check the peak meters, and I'm looking for as loud as possible without hitting zero or turning red. So this looks good. Now with the video done, I can add other elements, like text and images, and animate those as well. All the standard GWD authoring is supported with video, and you'll find a lot of instructional content on the GWD YouTube channel if you're just getting started. I'm just going to add a logo and have it slide into view at the end. I can preview on stage with these controls. You can use this for quick feedback, and it's easy to make timing adjustments. When everything is done, I'll publish, which means exporting the MP4 video. Select locally, and here I have a few choices for output, which could be used to reduce the export time when testing. But in this case, I'll leave it at full resolution and export. When this is done, I'll close the dialog, and now I open my project folder to find the resulting MP4 video in its own folder, and just double-click it to open in your default video player. I just want to quickly mention some advanced features. Masking is supported with all the usual tools, for example, a simple oval, and these can be animated with keyframes. CSS effects can be applied to video with blend modes and filters, like grayscale, which turns my video black and white. And these can also be animated as well. Set a couple keyframes. Change the slider. And here's the final effect. And one last thing is dynamic support. Right-click a clip to add a binding to the endpoint or source. Then create a new variant and change its source. A variant is a version of this dynamic file which is populated with all the content set in this panel, so you can have different video and audio clips, text, images, colors, and more. Here's a variant of this file that I've already set up, and I'll play it to demonstrate. And when publishing dynamic files, I'll get a new option to choose which variants to include. That's it for video editing in Google Web Designer. Thanks for watching.